Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about a subject that I love, different programming languages. And especially server-side scripting languages. Which one to choose? Which one is worth investing time and energy in? Which language is worth choosing for backend development between PHP, Python, Node.js, and Ruby? Which language to learn? I love learning new technologies, so if I could, I would say to learn them all. But life is short, and time is precious. And these four languages each had different strengths and weaknesses and use cases. We'll look at them together, and by the end, I hope I'll have helped you make your choice. And a small detail before going any further. I've limited myself to scripting languages to avoid making too long a video and to stay on a subject that I know well. That's why I'm not taking a look at ASP.NET or Java. So let's see who are the forces in play. Python was created in 1991 and version 3 was created in 2008. Then we have PHP, which was created in 1994. Ruby was created in 1995 and finally Node.js was created in 2009. But the language is an extension of JavaScript, which was created in 1995. Let's examine all these different languages according to different criteria. For each of these, I'll distribute a total of 10 points. To do so, I'll rely on two sources of information. The first of these is the Stack Overflow Developer Survey, since it measures how developers rate different languages. And also the 3 Tech website, which measures real-world usage for different server technologies. Now, why is it interesting to look at this number? Well, it shows real-world popularity. And it gives an indicator of the level of opportunities there are to find a job. And so here is the usage of different languages on the servers where the language is known. Python has a 1.3 usage rate. Then comes Node.js with a 1.9% usage rate. Then we have Ruby, which has over 6%. And finally, we have PHP with a whopping 78%. PHP is the foundation on which Wikipedia, Facebook, and of course WordPress were all built. And to be honest, WordPress alone is present on 40% of all websites, at least those whose technology we know. That leaves only 38% of sites using PHP once we ignore WordPress. That's still a factor of 6 compared to the nearest competitor, which is Ruby. And so with almost 80% of usage rate in PHP and 6% for Ruby, I'll give 8 points to PHP and 1 to Ruby. And 0 to the remainder. Now let's take a look at the Stack Overflow Developer Survey for 2021. We'll start by looking at two questions this survey asks. The first question is, this language, do you love it or do you hate it? This question is interesting because it reflects the satisfaction and frustration of developers. It's also a good indicator of what we could call DX or developer experience. But it's also an indicator of the consistency of the language and the level of community. The second question is, do you want to work in this language? Do you desire to work in this language? This reflects the attractiveness of the language. For each language, we'll take the rate of people who like it minus the rate of people who don't like it, and this will give us a net satisfaction score. Then we'll add the attractiveness rate. So, what does that result in for the different languages? For PHP, 40% of developers say they like it, but 60% say they don't. This gives us a net score of minus 20 percentage points, and only 2.5% of developers want to work in this language. So that's a total score of minus 17.5 for PHP. For Ruby, the situation is slightly less grim. We're just above an equal split, 53% love it, 40% hate it, which is a net score of plus 6 percentage points. And the attractiveness of Ruby is only slightly higher than that of PHP at 2.6%. That makes a total of 6 plus 2.5, 8.5. Then comes Node.js with 63% of positive opinions against 37% of negative opinions. So that's a net satisfaction score of plus 26. And the attractiveness of Node.js is at 12%. So we have a total score of 26 plus 12, 38. Oh, and by the way, for your information, TypeScript, which can be used with Node.js, has a 73% approval rating, and its attractiveness is at 15%. So here it would have a total of 61. Now, I'm not going to include it in the Node.js total here, but it's worth mentioning. Finally, Python has 68% positive reviews against 30% negative reviews. So a net satisfaction score of plus 36. Taking into account the attractiveness of 19%, this gives it a total score of 55. Compared to the minus 17 and some of PHP, Ruby has 26 points more, Node.js has 56 points more, and Python has 73 points more. If I add all this up and divide each score by the total, we now have percentages that add up to 100, and we can use that to assign points. So this gives us 0 points for PHP, 1 point for Ruby, 4 points for Node.js, and 5 points for Python. If we look at the current score, we have, for the moment, in the last place, Ruby, with 2 points in total. Then Node.js, which has 4 points. Finally, Python has 5 points. And lastly, PHP has 8 points. Now let's talk about money and salaries. More exactly, median salaries. Stack Overflow asked developers all over the world what their annual salary was. Obviously, the global situation doesn't necessarily translate to each country, but it does give us an indicator. For a given technology, they identified the salary that had as many people paid more as people paid less. So that gives us the median salary for that technology. It's worth noting that the median is a better indicator than the mean or the average, especially when there are disparities. And when it comes to salaries, things are rarely even. So let's take a look at these median salaries across the different languages. For PHP, that median salary is $39,000, or $35,000 for you, those of you who speak in euros. For Node.js next, that median salary is $55,000, or 50,000 euros. Next is Python, for which the median salary is $59,000, or 53,000 euros. And finally, Ruby is in the lead with $80,000, or 72,000 euros. Now let's do a calculation similar to the previous question. If we calculate the difference between these amounts and the lowest of them, that's PHP, then we translate each differential to a percentage. That gives us for this round, in last position, PHP with 0 points. In second position, Node.js with 2 points. In third position, Python with 3 points. And in first place, Ruby with 5 points. The accumulated scores are now Node.js in last place, with 6 points, Ruby in third place with 7 points, and joint first, PHP and Python with 8 points. As you can see, the scores are close, but for very different reasons. What could justify choosing one over the other? And here comes another subtlety worth mentioning. The syntax of PHP and JavaScript are both inspired by C. For example, curly brackets define code blocks. On the other hand, Python and Ruby are, relatively speaking, closer to each other, at least visually. For example, blocks are defined by the def keyword. Even though indentation has a syntactic importance in Python that it doesn't have in Ruby. Now, what could make the difference between one language or the other? Well, this is where the objective side of numbers finds its limit. Truth be told, it all depends on what you want to do more generally, what your ambitions are, and how averse you are to risk. Let me explain. First, let's take the case of Python. To be honest, the major use case of Python is actually data and machine learning. These offer interesting opportunities and salaries, but they also require a certain appetite for math. Python, as a server-side language, is a marginal use case compared to the three other languages. But if you know you want to go into backend development, and if you're worried about finding a job, you can't ignore PHP. It's not an exciting solution today, but it's reliable and it's solid. And as a side note, if you want to find freelancing work, it's worth understanding how WordPress works. But PHP's median salary is the lowest of all four. Conversely, there are fewer opportunities in Ruby, but there are also fewer skilled developers. This means that the salaries are higher in Ruby. So that's why I mentioned earlier that it all depends on your risk aversion. If you want job security, best go for PHP. If you're not afraid of risk, but you want a higher salary, Ruby can be a good solution, a good path. And finally, we have Node.js. Here, the situation is slightly different. Node.js is a variant of JavaScript. And as the Stack Overflow survey shows, almost 70% of developers use JavaScript. That means it's essential to know JavaScript and ideally TypeScript if you want to be competitive. Oh, by the way, that's precisely why I'm working on creating online courses on JavaScript and TypeScript. If you're interested, I've added details in the description. My recommendation then is to learn TypeScript and JavaScript, and then a second language, depending on what you want to do or the security you want to have. There's Python if you're interested in data science and math. There's Ruby if you're not afraid of risk and want to try and get a job that pays more. And then there's the safe solution, PHP. It's also the easy solution if you already speak JavaScript, but it's probably not the most exciting one. And if you're wondering, after all this, which path to choose between backend and frontend development, here's a video to help you choose. I'll see you there.